The crucial point for me is that it says, I would prefer not to. Not, I don't prefer to do it. So it's not that a predicate is denied, it is that a non-predicate is asserted. And I will say, what's the difference? Kant gives a wonderful difference, establishes it, which is why he's for me the greatest theorist of zombies. Look, if I tell you, you are not dead, I deny a predicate. What does this mean? It means simply you are alive if you are not dead. But if I say, and I hope you know Stephen King and all that, if I tell you not you are not dead, but you are undead, this means something different, living dead, monster, and so on. And this, between the two domain, this is, in a way, the domain of spirit, in the wonderful ambiguity of the word. Spirit, Geist, means spirit as pure thinking, and Geister, those who make us fear, terrorize us. And I think this ambiguity is crucial.
Das erinnert mich an einen Witz, den Sie immer so gerne erzählen. Der Witz, in dem es um die Betonung geht, der Negativität. Sie erzählen immer diesen Witz von einem Gast, der in ein Restaurant kommt. Er bestellt einen Kaffee ohne Rahm und der Kellner sagt, leider haben wir keinen Rahm mehr, ich bringe Ihnen einen Kaffee ohne Milch. Geht das
auch?
Weil
wir nur Milch haben, ja.
Genau, weil wir nur Milch haben. Warum ist es ein Unterschied, Kaffee ohne Milch oder Kaffee ohne Rahm?
Ah, you see, in meiner Volksrepublik, where I would have been in a minister, you would get 2 years of re-education camp, not gulag. Because this is what Hegel is about. This is the best example of what Hegel calls bestimmte Negation, determinate negation, that negation is part of what an object is, what it did not. So, of course, materially, coffee without milk is the same as coffee without cream. It's just plain coffee.
Genau.
But it's not the same. And this, precisely because it matters what it negates, and I will give you a wonderful variation of this joke from my youth. When, you know, I lived in a communist country, it wasn't too bad, liberal communism, but nonetheless, you didn't get things all the time.
In Slovenien aufgewachsen, ja.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And I remember the joke was this one, because there were things, somebody enters a store and asks there, is it that you still don't have butter? And the person there answers, sorry, you're the wrong store. We are the store which doesn't have oil. The store which doesn't have butter is across the street there, you know. Like this is, and again, I could give, I think that even...
Ja, aber was ist jetzt genau übertragen auf den Alltag? Sie haben ja gesagt, ich soll da in das Erziehungslager gehen. Was lerne ich da bezüglich dem Alltag?
I will refer to philosophical everyday. Oh, sorry, ideological everyday. That's, I think, one of the ways, but I don't have time to explain it now, it will take too long time, how ideology cheats. It offers you coffee and it implies that it's coffee without milk, but it's really coffee without cream. That's like, and this background, what is missing, but it's there, it's crucial. Let me give you another example that I use in my books of how this unmentioned background functions. In a nice old English leftist film, Brushed Off, you have one of the most erotic scenes that I've ever seen, with Ewan McGregor plays. He plays an ordinary worker who is in love with some young manager girl. He accompanies her home and she invites him up. She tells him, would you like to come up for a coffee to my apartment? He says, I would love to, but unfortunately I don't drink coffee. You know what she answers? No problem, I don't have any. Can you imagine a more direct erotic invitation? But precisely nothing dirty is said. And this phenomena, they embody ideology, how it functions in everyday life. I like them. You know, it's for me like Grundphänomen, zero level of ideology. I'm always fascinated by it. So-called gestures which are meant to be rejected. Like, let's say we are in a restaurant. You are rich, I am poor. You invite me. I think you have it here in this country also, as in my country. Even if we both know that you will pay, when the bill arrives,
Dann beginnen wir zu streiten.
Yes, yes, I should insist a little bit, not too much, because if I insist too much, you are evil, you can say, okay, then you pay if you want. But you see, so the result is zero. Nonsense. I did something, I knew it will be rejected. But the magic of everyday ideology is that, although the result was zero, nonetheless, our link was established. The link of kindness, you know, the signal was we are polite to each other, maybe we like each other. This is where ideology is alive.